Welcome back. Josh here from Absolute. If you recall, last time we saw how the HIPAA privacy rule tells us which data need protection. In this episode, we'll explore the HIPAA security rule to see how to protect that data. The security rule spells out safeguards that are like having a map, a compass, and coordinates that guides you toward data protection utopia. And there are three safeguard buckets: administrative, physical, and technical. Administrative safeguards create an atmosphere where data protection is just woven into the day-to-day operation. Physical safeguards are the observable and tangible garrisons for PHI. Things like locked rooms, server cages, secure workstations, disposal facilities. And then there are technical safeguards, where technology itself gets pressed into service to shield our most valuable data. Access controls enable users to get to the minimum necessary to prevent unauthorized access to PHI. Audit controls are the hardware, software, and procedures that examine systems to validate those defenses. That's right, there is a federal law demanding that every device, app, server, network connection, and so forth, all go under the microscope. Integrity controls helps to make sure that health data is never altered or destroyed in any unauthorized way. This is probably the biggest challenge when scaling Mount HIPAA compliance. Recently, a federal judge upheld a penalty for more than $4 million on a world-renowned healthcare provider when they were unable to prove that a missing laptop was secure. That's expensive. Administrative, physical, and technical safeguards are not suggestions, but legal requirements for anyone working with health data. Protecting PHI is hard. Protecting PHI on far-flung devices is even harder. But when you have line of sight and continuously monitor all the pockets where PHI can hide, you can leap over those hurdles and satisfy the security rule. Be sure to drop your questions in the comments section below, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time.